Today I'm going to explain the Bluetooth concept. Okay, like in previous class, in previous video, I taught IEEE standards and different frame length and frame format. Everything we discussed. Okay, today I'm going to explain the Bluetooth. Okay, what is the first of all Bluetooth? Okay, Bluetooth. Okay, it is one of the wireless device. Okay, like you know, all of you know that. The Bluetooth is a wireless network. Okay, the wireless LAN technology, it is going to design to connect the devices of the different function, okay, such as the telephone, computer, laptop, desktop, camera, printer, okay, everything. Okay, so this we call it as a Bluetooth. And then the Bluetooth technology, okay, it have these several applications. Okay, what are the applications of the Bluetooth technology? Means, okay, our peripheral device such as the wireless mouse or keyboard, okay, these are the our peripheral devices. Okay, along with that we have more than that. Okay, our peripheral device is nothing but keyboard, mouse, joystick, and what is that, joystick and platter. These all are the like different types of the peripheral device. Okay, our like USB port, USB cables, okay, these all are our peripheral devices to communicate with the computer through this technology. Okay, means like all our peripheral device, it is going to interact with the with the Bluetooth technology with the help of the computer. So then monitor device, okay, it is going to communicate with the help of the sensor device. Okay, and this sensor device, okay, it is a very small small devices. Okay, it is going to make the make the connection established by at the health center, small health center. Okay, this is what our monitor device, it is going to help at the healthcare center. Then our home security devices can also use the Bluetooth technology or to like to connecting the different sensor. Okay, see, means when we connecting the different sensor at the home, okay, to provide the security of all the people. So this is what our the Bluetooth technology. The next one is the architecture of the Bluetooth technology. Okay, what are the architecture it contains? The first of all, this architecture, it contains the based on the two network. The first one is the PicoNet as well as the ScatterNet. Okay, then PicoNet, okay, it is nothing but it is a small network. Okay, then our Bluetooth network, we call it as a PicoNet network. Then our PicoNet network, it can have the up to 8 station. Okay, means the number of station it can have that particular PicoNet network, it means, okay, it have the maximum number of the PicoNet will be 8. Okay, then one of which is called as the primary. Okay, in that 8 station, okay, one of the station we call it as a primary station. Okay, then in other station we call it as a secondary station. Okay, the secondary station, it is going to synchronize their clock as well as the frequency hopping, everything, I mean the frequency hopping, everything will be sequentially, it is going to ordered, means it is going to set by the sequence order. Okay, with the help of the primary station. Here our PicoNet, network, okay, whatever the information it have the primary station, okay, that is going to communicate between the secondary station as well as the primary station. It means nothing but one-to-one communication or one-to-many communication. Primary station, it is going to distribute all other siblings station, means that is nothing but our secondary station, and along with that, it is going to transaction takes place between the primary as well as the secondary. Okay, so this is what our one of the main architecture about Bluetooth. So see, you look at this, the Bluetooth, see here, this is what our PicoNet. See, PicoNet here, see, it is going to act as the two case, means it is going to interact with the point to point as well as one to many, means one station it is going to circulate all the information to other. So this method we call it as a one to many, or one to one, means point to point. Otherwise, because it is going to individually, it is going to take care of the transaction, or it is going to making the transaction between the primary as well as the secondary. That we call it as a one to one transaction. So this is what our PicoNet. Here the primary devices is a one of the root device. Okay, it is going to take care all the transaction. Based on this primary devices, our all the secondary devices it is going to interact. Then what is the scatter net? Okay, the scatter net is nothing but our PicoNet can be combined to combined to in the form of our scatter net, means all our PicoNet network it is going to combine in the Bluetooth. Okay, Bluetooth network, that we call it as a scatter network. Here the secondary station in one PicoNet that can be act as a another primary PicoNet, means the secondary station or the secondary device of that particular Pico network, okay, that can be act as the primary of the another device of that particular PicoNet. See, this station can be receive the messages, means another PicoNet primary PicoNet device is there, right? That device it is going to access, or that device it is going to receive all the information at the receiver side. Then that receiver message, okay, it is going to receive from the primary in the first PicoNet, okay, as a secondary device that is going to act as the primary, okay, when it is going to deliver to the other secondary devices. See, this secondary device it is going to act as a second PicoNet station. That station can be a member of the two PicoNet. Okay, so this is what our scatter. See, you will look at this. So this is what the scatter net. Okay, initially it is going to making the transaction between one to many. Okay, after that, see, our primary station it is going to transaction between two different secondary devices. Okay, see, during that time it is going to receive the messages. That message again it is going to send back the primary. Okay, like that it is going to transaction will be taken place. So this is what our scatter net. Here our primary device it is going to act both primary as well as the secondary devices sometimes. So this is what our scatter net. The next one is Bluetooth layer. Okay, our Bluetooth layer it is going to contain the different types of layer. Okay, and usually it contains the several layers. Okay, what are that all the layers? Okay, it is going to matches with this all the Bluetooth layer. It is going to matches with the internet layer or internet mode. See, first one is the radio layer, baseband layer. Okay, and this is the L2 cap layer. And data, this is the profiles. Okay, then the application. Okay, this the like in this profiles, data and L2 cap layer. Okay, it contain the audio as well as the control, means both the option, means both both the method is supposed to use. One is audio method as well as the control method. The control method is going to control all the all the functions here, and that function it is going to send in the form of audio. So this is what our Bluetooth. Then in Bluetooth, the first layer or the first method we discuss the radio layer. The radio layer, it is a roughly equivalent to the physical layer of the internet model, as well as the Bluetooth device are very low power of and have a range of 10 meter. Then this radio layer, it contains the band FHS, means frequency hopping spectrum. Okay, then how much the bandwidth of the our Bluetooth? Usually our Bluetooth it can use the 2.4 gigahertz. Okay, bandwidth it is going to divide into 79 channels of the channels of 1 kilo megahertz or 1 megahertz for each. Okay, each channel it have the 1 megahertz. So this is what our bandwidth. Okay, then frequency hopping spectrum. Okay, it is basically